subscribe my channel. P. Sarala. Hit the bell icon so that you are notified every time I post a new lesson. Welcome to class. Today we are discussing about why do we fall ill, which is a chapter 11 in 8th class biology. So in this chapter we are going to learn about what is health, what are diseases, what are the causes for diseases, and the types of diseases, how we can prevent the diseases. These are the objectives of this lesson. So first one, health. So what is health? Physical, mental and social well-being is known as health. So health depends on the personal and social issues. So personal health depends mainly on the economic conditions, social equality and harmony. Next, what is disease? So disease is being uncomfortable, which may be physical, mental or social, or disturbed is known as disease. When we talk about health, we include society and communities. When we talk about disease, we think about individual sufferers. So that is the main difference between health and the disease. In the examination, what is the difference between health and a disease means, health we consider the society and the community. When come to disease, we think about individual sufferer. Okay. Next, types of diseases. Depending upon several factors, diseases are divided into three categories. So number one is depending on time duration, diseases are two types. So depending upon the time, how long or how the disease is present is known as a time duration. So first one is acute disease. So these are the diseases which last only for short period of time, only 3 or 4 days or 1 week. So that type of diseases are known as acute diseases, example cold. Next, chronic diseases. So these are the diseases which last for a long time, even for lifetime. So such diseases are known as chronic diseases, example elephantiasis. Otherwise it is also known as filariasis, which lasts for a lifetime. So depending upon causes of diseases, diseases are two types. So the organisms which cause disease, depending on that, diseases are two types, infectious diseases and non-infectious diseases. So infectious diseases are the diseases caused by the microbes or microorganisms, example cholera, typhoid, etc. Non-infectious diseases, so these are not caused by the microorganisms, but the reason for these diseases are genetic abnormalities or disorders and lifestyle diseases, example blood pressure, cancer and obesity. So these are non-infectious diseases. Peptic ulcers, once they are thought that they are the non-infectious diseases because they occur due to the stress. So peptic ulcer is a disease which occurs to the parts of stomach and duodenum, that is inflammation of stomach and duodenum, that is the acidity, is known as peptic ulcer. So Robin Warren and Barry Marshall, these are the two scientists from country Australia. They found that peptic ulcers are not due to non-infectious disease, but these are due to a bacterium which is known as Helicobacter pylori. So Helicobacter pylori bacterium causes peptic ulcers. Okay, so for this finding they receive Nobel Prize for Physiology and Medicine in 2005. So in DSE or TET examination. So you have to remember these two. So peptic ulcer is caused by which bacterium? That is Helicobacter pylori. So who discovered Helicobacter pylori? Means Robin Warren and Marshall are the two scientists. They belong to the country Australia. So like this you have to prepare. From these two findings you can get four questions, like what is the name of the bacteria which causes peptic ulcer, who are the scientists who discovered Helicobacter pylori, and when these scientists got Nobel Prize, in which branch of science they got Nobel Prize. Like that you have to prepare for the examination. Next, depending on the spread of disease, diseases are two types, communicable diseases and non-communicable diseases. So communicable diseases are also known as contagious diseases. So they spread from one person to another, one person, that is an affected person, to another healthy person is known as communicable diseases. Example is cold. Now we are facing COVID-19 is also communicable disease. Next, non-communicable diseases. So they do not spread from one person to another. Example, cancer. So severity of the disease depend upon the number of microbes present in the body. So if the fewer number of microorganisms present in the body, so only the slight symptoms appear. So at this stage, if we kill the bacteria or microorganisms, the spread of the disease can be prevented. Diseases can be spread by the sources like air, water, and vectors. So vectors are the organisms which transfer pathogens from one person to other persons. Next, disease may be spread by the contact. The contact may be physical contact or the sexual contact. So sexual contacts the disease AIDS is spread by the sexual contact or blood transfusion or from the mother to the fetus which is present in the womb of a pregnant lady. So likewise the diseases are by several factors. So what are the agents which cause diseases? So these agents are known as infectious agents. They are microorganisms, virus, bacteria, fungi, some protozoans and helminth parasites act as infectious agents. So these infectious agents may be unicellular or multicellular. Okay, how can we treat diseases? So the principles of treatment, there are two ways to treat diseases. The first one is to control the disease and second one to kill the cause of the disease. So control means we can control the spread of the disease. Okay, next one, kill the cause of the disease. So this is the best method. By killing the bacterium or the virus or the microorganism, we can stop the spreading of the diseases. So killing of the microorganisms depends upon the specific biochemical mechanisms of microorganisms. Their own biochemical mechanisms helps to kill the microorganism. For example, bacteria forms a cell wall. So the penicillin, the antibiotic penicillin, which is discovered by Alexander Fleming. So the antibiotic penicillin impedes the formation of cell wall in bacteria. So it does not encourage the formation of cell wall. So it stops the formation of the cell wall. The bacteria dies. But virus do not have cell wall. Like human being cell also doesn't contain cell wall. So these antibiotics doesn't affect the virus and the human cells. That's why antibiotics do not kill the virus. Antibiotics kills only the bacteria but not the virus. How can we prevent the disease? So prevention is better than cure. So preventing a disease is better than curing the disease. So it occurs by two ways. So So first two prevention is a general prevention, and the second one is a specific prevention of a disease. General, so it is the general immunity of the individual for variety of microorganisms. So the immunity of a person, immunity of an individual helps to prevent the disease. So some are more immune, they have their immune system is very well developed. Some may not have, so they are susceptible for the various diseases. So the immunity depends upon the food also and genetics. Next one, specific prevention. So this is by immunization or by vaccination. So by taking the vaccines to a particular disease, we can prevent that disease. Example, vaccination for smallpox prevents the occurrence of smallpox. Okay, so father of immunization is Edward Jenner. So vacca is the Latin word, so which means cow. So vaccinia means cowpox. So from this vaccinia, the word vaccination came. So a mild amount of smallpox virus is injected into a healthy person, and that person develops immunity against the smallpox. So that is about the prevention methods. So these are some of the diseases which are caused by the microorganisms and how they are spread. So take a screenshot of this and you revise one or two times so that you can easily remember the disease name, infectious agent and spread of the disease. Example, malaria, which is caused by a protozoan named Plasmodium. So it is spread by the bite of female Anopheles mosquito. Okay, like this you can remember all the disease names and the infectious agent. I hope you understood.